So whenever I start a creative project that's really important to me, whenever I get the first draft out, I am like appalled. I cannot see the light at the end of the tunnel. I think it's going nowhere. I think that I suck. And through the process of revising and editing, I always prove myself wrong. A lot of the time as artists, we have the first draft and we're like, it's not good. We give up. We suck at this. But everyone's first draft is supposed to suck. Editing is the lifeblood. And in this video, I wanna share with you two specific videos and going through the revision process with you. And the reason why I wanna go over this today is because I feel like it will show you how important revising your work is. So first, we're gonna go over a video that I had just released called Always On My Mind, and it's a poetry video. I had uploaded this video, and after the video's been out for a day, I go to sleep, I check on it in the morning, and then I rewatch it, and I'm just like horrified.
I realized that I was more focused and excited about getting the video out rather than taking the time to make much needed revisions that the video deserved. So I ended up taking this video down.
And it was a little bit of a tough decision because I have never done that. Any video that I've released, once it's out, it's out. But this was bothering me so bad.
So I'm going to play the deleted video for you right now.
If you've already seen it, you can skip through this part, but I'm gonna play it and we can watch it together for those of you who have not seen. If you just wanna see the final result, I will link it in the description. If you don't care about any of this, you can just check out the final result in the description below.
After we are done watching the deleted version, I'm going to be doing some live edits and revisions to the video right here with you. And then we will watch the final version of the video together. Lastly, I'll be going over with you my reasoning behind making some of the creative decisions that I had made in not only this poetry video, but another one as well. All right, here we go. He said he was trying to go to bed, but he said he was thinking about me. And then he said every song reminds me of you, and I was thinking, but baby, everything reminds me of you. You're on my mind on the drive to work and the drive back too. And I think about you when I brush my teeth. You even crossed my mind when I was buying apples at the grocery store, when I'm doing chores, making the bed, or even when I'm setting my alarm for the next morning to wake up bright and early just to remind me to think about you again. You're the absolute mindfuck of the century because I'm thinking about you even when I'm not thinking about you. And last night you said every song reminds me of you, and I guess I could say the same, but I'm reminded of you by every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too.
Overall, these are the things that I don't really like about it. I want the music to be a little bit louder, and there's some parts too where I didn't like my delivery. Another important thing to note here is, like, at least with these poetry videos, is a lot of the time you can have a poem, and then when you're turning it into a poetry video, or when I'm turning it into a poetry video, the idea and the concept of it kind of changes. And that's because it's going to be perceived and interpreted differently when you're reading a poem. That's much different than being read a poem. So for example, spoken word. That's why spoken word is different than written poetry. So the same thing goes for a poetry video. When it's realized in the video form, a lot of the times I have to change and tweak things in order for it to hit the same. So I want to begin first by showing you guys the very first draft of this poem, and I'll read it to you. This was how I originally wrote the poem and how it's supposed to be when you read it. He said he was trying to go to bed, but he said he was thinking about me, and then he said, every song reminds me of you, and I'm thinking, but baby, everything reminds me of you. You're on my mind on the drive to work and the drive back too, when I think about you when I brush my teeth, and you even cross my mind when I'm buying apples at the grocery store or when I look at the sky. I'm even thinking about you when I'm not thinking about you, and last night you said every song reminds me of you, and I guess I could say the same, but baby, I'm reminded of you by every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too.
always on my mind.
Hopefully that wasn't too cringy. When I had that poem and I started putting it over video footage, it was too short. It didn't feel like there was a climax. It kind of felt like it just ended. Then that's why I went in and I added this bar when I'm doing chores, making the bed, this, just to make it like a little bit longer. So that was the creative decision behind that. And then something really small is I changed this verse to past tense. So in the original poem, it was, "You even cross my mind when I'm buying apples at the grocery store." And for some reason, when I verbalized it in the video, it made sense to put it in past tense as a singular event rather than as I think about you every single time I buy apples at the grocery store. So now I am going to pull up my project file right now and we are gonna edit this live. If you just wanna see the final results, go ahead and check the link in the description. So one thing I'm looking at right now is my audio levels, and I'm looking at that right over here. So you usually want them to peak between negative 12 and negative 18. That's just what I've heard. There are different philosophies on that. That has been the philosophy that I have been living by. You can hear that the music is like peaking there. So I want, like I said earlier, I want the music to be a little bit louder. So I'm gonna raise this by probably like 5 dB. Let's see how that sounds.
He said he was trying.
So I am going to lower my voice by negative 3 dB. So right here also, you can tell that I'm already lowering the volume. This is a exponential fade. For those who don't know video editing lingo, that just means it gradually makes the sound of this specific clip decrease. So it's decreasing right before the drop. So this part is the sound level of this file is decreasing before this. So I kind of don't want that, but way better. I'm not completely sold, but I think it might sound cool if this beginning part, since I'm like on my phone, what if it sounded radio telephone-ish, like it was coming from a voicemail or something like that? So I'm gonna try it out.
And I was thinking, but baby, everything reminds me of you.
So I like it. So this whole part, this whole end part, so I wanna re-record that. This could potentially be very cringe. You're the absolute mind fuck of the century. And last night you said chord, octave. I'm reminded of you by every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too. All right, let's see if one of those works.
He said he was trying to go to bed, but he said he was thinking about me. And then he said every song reminds me of you. And I was thinking, but baby, everything reminds me of you.
You're on my mind on the drive to work and the drive back too. And I think about you when I brush my teeth. You even crossed my mind when I was buying apples at the grocery store, when I'm doing chores, making the bed, or even when I'm setting my alarm for the next morning to wake up bright and early just to remind me to think about you again. You're the absolute mindfuck of the century because I'm thinking about you even when I'm not thinking about you. Last night you said every song reminds me of you, and I guess I could say the same, but I'm reminded of you by every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too.
All right, hello, so I am back. So that actually took me
a little bit longer than I had originally anticipated, thus the whole scenery switch. This is actually being recorded a few days later. But right now, what I want to go over is some creative decisions that I made. As you know, as creatives, when we release a project, it's not like the decisions that we made about that project or that song or that video. It's not like they're an accident. They're very intentional. So I want to share you some intentional decisions that I made. Maybe you have the same creative process. I would love to know what you think about the decisions that I made and the things that I changed. Do you think they were the right move? What would you have done? Do you do similar processes? I'm really curious to know about you, so let me know. But I'm specifically right now just gonna go through certain sections of the videos and explain why I made those decisions. I wanted to differentiate the intro world with the actual world of the poem.
But baby, everything reminds me of you.
You're on my mind on the...
So I changed that part to sound like it was coming from a phone because I wanted the difference between the worlds to be reflected in an auditory way. And then this part.
Because I'm thinking about you even when I'm not thinking about you.
But let me show you the original one.
Thinking about you even when I'm not thinking about you.
So in the original version, I wanted to resemble that visually by myself dancing and doing chores, like because I'm doing chores, but obviously I'm thinking about something else. So I thought that I wanted to resemble that visually that way, but I didn't think that the words and the shots matched because there's a lot of like sorrow in my voice. And I felt like that was a little bit too happy for just that specific part. It's the climax in a way, like I'm even thinking about you when I'm not thinking about you, like goddamn, you know? So that's why I changed it to me looking a little bit more sad in the car.
You even when I'm not thinking about you.
So then I also changed the ending part.
Last night you said every song reminds me of you.
In this part, I was trying to, with the visuals, like even when I'm out with my friends drinking, I'm like checking my phone, thinking about you. But I don't know, something about it just felt really random. And so that's why I circled back to some of the shots from the beginning of the video.
Last night you said every song reminds me of you.
And then the ending, let's go back to the original.
I'm reminded of you by every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too.
And I guess that's okay. I tried to do a montage of all of the little moments to kind of say, this is the instrument, this is the chord, and this is the half note. I tried to do like a montage of all of the moments, but sometimes when you reuse a shot that you've already used, it makes it less powerful. So I try not to do that. I also felt that because it was like reaching the end of the video that it should get like a little bit more hype. So that's why in the later version, I added these shots instead.
Every instrument, chord, octave, and half note too.
If you are a really close listener, you'll be able to hear that I added some layers in the audio as well. I did that in both versions. I love how layering sounds comes across, especially if they're like in different tones and if you layer them on top of each other. I feel like it gives a very like scatterbrained effect, like there's so many thoughts happening at once. So then the last creative decision I made this same decision in both the original and the revised, but just how the whole world in the video is color graded like VHS, I wanted the journal scene to be the only one that's not color graded, therefore resembling that this is in the actual world. Me writing this poem is happening in the real world, and everything that you're seeing is happening in my head. But before I wrap this video up, I want to show you one more thing just to show to you guys how important it is to revise your work. And if you don't like something, change it. Because if you don't like it, the chances are pretty high that someone else isn't going to like it. Like if you're not in love with it, no one else can be in love with it. But I also want to draw a very careful distinction. There's a distinction between not liking the work and having watched it so many times that you hate it. You don't even know if it's good anymore. And I think as creatives, we should be spending that much time on our personal projects. Put your all into everything. You need to get to the point where you love it, but you hate it so much because you've spent so much time with it. So I want to show you another poetry video, and I'm going to show you a first draft, which is something that I
don't really share to anybody. So I think it's important though. So here I am going from sharing it with no one to sharing it on YouTube. But for the poetry video that I made called Pretty, I'll also link it in the description below. It came from a poem that I wrote where I just felt incredibly alone. I was with my thoughts just on the couch and I wrote something in the notes app on my phone. And I was inspired to make the poetry video, not necessarily by the poem. It wasn't like I wrote this poem and I was like, oh my God, it's so good. This is a groundbreaking poem. I need to do a poetry video about it. It was more like the feeling. I was like, I want to evoke this feeling through a poetry video. So I want to show you the first draft. It's pretty bad. It does a lot of telling and not a lot of showing. Not really artistic, but it's a first draft. Your first draft is supposed to suck. It's supposed to. And it doesn't even matter if it's a poem or an essay or whatever. Like, the first draft, it's not supposed to be perfect. We can't let that discourage us. Like, the creation process of being creative, it's literally editing and revising. That's all it is. It's getting the idea out here, just something that you can revise. That's the most important part, is get it out of here and put it here, out into the real world, and then you revise it, and that's art. So this was the very first draft of Pretty, and then I'm gonna show you why I ended up making some decisions and why it ended up looking the way that it did. I'll link in the description below the poetry video to Pretty if you want to watch that first, and this part will make more sense. So this is the very first draft.
I resented this city at first, because I woke up one day and I was undoubtedly, unmistakably, unshakably alone. And no one to call to tell that I felt alone. Felt like no one understands kind of alone. That kind of alone. I take myself out to eat. I watch TV in solitude. I cook dinner with no one to tell about my day. And I go to the beach by myself. Crickets began to feel like the soundtrack to my life, but the thing is, I began to not mind it so much. It was silent, but it was beautiful. It was lonely, but it was beautiful. And sometimes I cried, but it was still beautiful.
So let me explain all the things wrong with it. So first, it was all too dark. How do I want to say this? Like, sometimes it's good to juxtapose things in order to convey the emotion even more. And I felt that overall it was too dark because it's a really sad poem. And the footage was very dark, obviously. And so I felt that I wasn't conveying the emotion very well. And again, this was me just getting something out there. I know that it's not going to be perfect when I first execute, but I just have to have something so that way I know what needs to be fixed. So I was like, I need to go and I need to get brighter shots of me in the sunshine. Second, I was like, the poem is telling too much and not showing. I'm telling you what I'm doing alone. I'm telling you I'm going to the beach by myself. I'm telling you I'm doing all these things, but I'm not really showing it. So the decision that I made was to use the metaphor of life being a comedy, because that more shows to the audience how I'm feeling. It describes how I'm feeling in a way that's beyond just simply saying it how it is. So this video, let's go over here, it literally has version 1, version 2, version 3, all the way up to version 15. So there were 15 versions of that before I was like, okay, this is how I want it to be. So I think as creatives, like whether we're making a video, a short film, a song, whatever it is, a poem, juxtaposing can be really, really effective in order to convey an emotion. So for example, like if there's a horror scene in a movie and there's like a happy lullaby song or like some classical music playing over somebody getting murdered, that's creepy. That evokes the creepiness emotion because of that juxtaposition. But I'm curious about you. What way do you juxtapose in order to convey emotion in your work? So overall, I just wanted to share this demo with you to show that the importance of just getting the first draft out, because you can't revise something or fix something that doesn't exist. And a lot of us get into this analysis paralysis because it's like not perfect in the plan or whatever.
And so we're afraid to just like even begin execution, or maybe we don't know how to do it. But you, I'm gonna say it again, you can't revise something, you can't fix something that doesn't exist.